He's actually there today and tomorrow. Yeah, he does, and they might be shutting down. So we're hoping to put down again. That's where we first started here. So, hello. Okay, I'm just gonna turn this a little bit so you guys can see Jess and I both. Okay. Oh yeah, working. You're all working.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Welcome to our workout. So what we have today, we're going to do a step and then a mat if you have it, and then a set of lighter weight dumbbells and or household supplies that you can use. If you don't have like a box, obviously if you're in a gym, we have this accessibility. If you're at home doing this, you can use a step, a stool, a chair, any kind of solid surface where you can get your full foot on there and step up on it. I've also done this at my on my fireplace at home, so whatever you have around that is a little bit higher than, you know, a couple inches off the ground. We want to be able to get our full foot on there and get a full hip extension at the top. Okay, but going into our exercises that we have, we are going to do a side bend knee to elbow. So if you just have one dumbbell is fine. I'm just going to go ahead and use both if I have them. But we're going to reach up. We're going to make sure that we're not overextending at the top. We want to keep our ribs connected to our pelvis, so our hip bones. And then we're going to bring our knee to elbow. Reach up, knee to elbow. So this is working on balance and stability in this stable leg. So once again, from the front, keep your ribs down, knee to elbow. So inhale up, exhale when you meet in the middle. And then we're going to do a squat hold and punch. So we're going to get our squat stance. That's beautiful, Amy. That's good. So we're going to do a squat hold and punch. So we drop into our squat position. Our knees are staying out, and we're punching side to side. Exhale with a punch. Inhale to center. All right, and then we'll do the side bend. Knee to elbow on the other side. There's my daughter, Daisy, living her best life. And then we're going to do calf raises. Hold your weight over your knees by your side, or in this front position. But we're just going to come up one, and then control your descent down. We're trying to stay in control of our body here. All right, that's our first circuit. Our second circuit is going to be getting into those step ups. So once again, we're going to get 6 inches or so away from whatever you're stepping up on. Get your whole foot on the box, and we're going to press to our heel to stand, and then we're going to switch our feet. Alternate feet every time. And then we're going to do some trunk lifts. So we're just going to hold whatever we're using in front of our belly button, and we're just going to twist. So what we're working on is getting some rotation through our core, our obliques are going to fire. We're keeping that belly button folded just gently as we twist. We're going to stick with the same side, and then we're going to do some halos. Up and around, start at the belly button, go up and around the head, we're alternating sides, and then we'll do trunk twists to the other side. All right, then for our last circuit, we're gonna get down on the ground.
Oh my goodness,
we're gonna get down on the ground. I'm gonna do it from a side view. I'm gonna hold this right here. Right. So this is going to be working on there should not be any space between your back and the floor. We engage our core, so our belly button's pulled down gently, our ribs are down. Lift our knees, lift our arms. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Extend. And come back together. Once again, that belly button stays pulled down, and that back is pressed into the mat, the floor. So this exercise can be a lot of mental gain at first, but then once you get the rhythm, you'll be moving pretty sweet. So then we're gonna do a bridge with a chest press. And change this up a little bit from the pull. But we're gonna do a bridge. Think about taking your knees to your toes, bridge, and we're gonna press up with the dumbbells. Down, up. Exhale with the press and the hip lift. And back down on the inhale. Then we're gonna flip it over. And we're gonna do some doggy kickbacks. So keep your foot flat, take your heels to the ceiling. On both sides. Alright, that's it. So those were our three circuits. Alright,
so we're gonna start our workout.
We're just gonna start with just some arm swings here. Our first circuit that we start with is pretty low key, so we'll get more different as we go. So we're gonna start with some arm swings up and down. Alright, let's get into arm circles. Forward and back. Alright. So we're gonna do some leg sweeps forward and back. So our core is engaged. If you need to hold on to something, feel free. But if you have proper core engagement, you should be able to do this without holding on to anything. Alright, then side to side. Cross body, then kick that leg out. And then other side. Forward and back. Pelvis is stable because our belly button is pulled in. Woo! Yeah, right? And cross body out. I'm touching you, Sally. All right, everybody. We'll get more warmed up as we go. I'll get my timer started. We've got a 10-second countdown. Grab whatever you're using. We're going to put the side knee to elbow. So we're going to reach up, lock our wrists down, knee to elbow. Yeah, Casey, we're using that for our workout, so we sure. Inhale up, exhale, come together. Your stabilized leg should be talking to you as well. Those glute muscles are firing to keep your balance. Feel a good crunch in those obliques as you pull your elbow down. Go into the squat, hold and punch, and two, one. All right, down. Drop your squat. Punch. Exhale with the punch. Try to square your shoulders off to the wall. Good tempo to the music. Stay in the leg. Breathe. Back for a second. We're going back to this side. Keep the elbow on the other side. All right, stand up. Reach up, inhale, ribs lock down. Stretch. central highlighters. All right, 10 seconds left. We're going to go to that side right here. Go. All right, let's grab our weights. That's really heavy, so be careful. All right. Inhale out, we need to throw up.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Feel it in the crash with your glutes. Your glutes working on that stick leg flag. Few more seconds. Go ahead and kind of check your fist. In 3, 2, 1. All right. Squat it down. Punch. Keep that belly button pulled in. So we're rotating through our mid back, not our low back. Yeah, there you go. We're balanced in our feet. Keeping our knees out. We got 7 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Side bends on the other side. Up. Pull it down. I'm going to crunch with my side abs here. I'm balanced in my feet. Less than 10. Cat raises. 5, 3, 2, 1. Alright, cat raise. Here we go. Yep. That is the 2. Pretty good. Do you know what the other number is? 10 is the 2. Very good. Strong up, roll down. She's good. She has
a little bit of touch.
Yeah. 5 seconds. 1. All right. Set those legs down. Keep your foot in. You got 1 more step. Just work it. Sorry. We got 8 seconds. Go ahead and grab our waist. Go back to the side bend you fell last time. Up and go. Pull it down. Boom. Think about leaning with your knee and your heel. Strong crunch on the side. Boom. Really feel those abs contract. 10 seconds here. Keep going with a squat, hold, punch. 3, 2, 1 more rep here. All right. Squat, hold, punch. Here we go. Punch it out. Try to drop even lower than your legs. Booty goes back and down. Belly button's in. Strong punches, throw the back leg. Here we go. Stay in those legs. Get to it. Less than 10. Go into the side bend. 3, 2, 1. All right, spin it up. Nice job. All right, reach up. Crunch it down. Exhale with that crunch. Strong abs here. Soft bend in the knee. Strong ankle, strong knee, strong hip on that straight leg. Less than 10. 3, 2, 1. Calf raises. Here we go. Strong up. And if you can find one, then you can have one. Rock up on those toes. Control your down. Down, here we go. Okay, calves. Lock it out at the top. 5 seconds, here we go. 1, and rest.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the hospital.
3 seconds. Going to chest press. All right. Strong in your legs. Twist. Keep your low back and low belly connected by pulling your belly button in. We're rotating from our mid back and our obliques. 10 seconds. Going to halos after this. Last time. Halos 3, 2, 1. All right. Here we go. Set that strong base in the move. Dropping your legs a little bit more. This is our last time. Keep that torso upright. Belly button folded. Less than 10 here. We got 5. Trunk twist, 3, 2, 1. Trunk twist to the right. Last time. Here we go. Exhale. With the twist. Oh, yeah. That felt like it. 10 seconds. Here we go, you guys. Stick with me here. Stay in those legs. Strong twist. We got 3, 2, 1. All right. We're going to our mats. This mat's okay. I just this one right here. Do a circle. Okay, can I have the green one underneath it? Okay. All right, so we're going to dead legs with no dumbbells. Hip bridge with chest press. Okay, I need it right here. And then the donkey kickbacks. And I put it right here. your heel, you can reach your hamstrings. Strong chest press with the weight. Exhale up and come down. A few more seconds. Two, one. All right. Roll it back over on all fours. Now we can back. And go. Keep that belly up until then so our pelvis is stable. We're pressing the floor away through our arms and our shoulders as we extend the leg. All right. then switch your feet. Drop in the back, stretch, nice. Hold for a little bit, and then we can start to drop. Okay, start rocking side to side with that heel. Alright, we're gonna let our legs go. We're gonna come up into a half kneeling position and stretch our hip flexors. So half kneeling here. Tuck your tail under, squeeze your cheek at that leg, and think of the leg that's down. Think of those hip flexors on the front side of your hip. Long meeting. Good. You can even reach across. Get in a little deeper of a stretch here. Make sure your low belly and your low back are connected so you're not pulling in your low back. You're going to be tight. We're just trying to deepen that stretch on the hip flexors. Big breath in, big exhale out. Breath, switch. Back your tail, squeeze that cheek. Front side of the hip goes long, then you can reach across. Keeping that stretch. Stay tall and keep breathing in this position. Big breath in. Big breath out. Gently release that. We're going to come into a staggered standing position. And we're just going to hinge forward and get a hamstring stretch out here. I think it's just a little washcloth. Try to keep your legs as straight as possible. If you do need to bend them a little bit, that's okay. But we're trying to get a good stretch on that hamstring. All right, gently release that. And then we're just going to twist around and turn towards the other direction. Same thing here. Flat back forward, good hinge. Keep those collarbones long. And breathe into the stretch.
I'm just going to move that a little bit away.
Come on, guys. Back up. We're just going to interlace our fingers behind our back. Last chest stretch here. Feel free to get into some neck circles. Lean with your nose. Do a big circle. 3 to 4 each way. Just breathe here. And then switch your direction. Feel free to drop into that bent over position like stress is. Rocking your hips. Whatever your body is telling you to be, listen to your body. All right. Woo! Feel free to keep stretching. We are done here. Jesse's turn to lead class, so have a great rest of your day. Thanks for joining me.